Here we have an example document, which is pretty common out there in the wild. We have punctuation mark, bold titles, underline titles, small bold titles. As a printout, this is fine, but for putting it online, it has to be made accessible, and this is not, for the simple reason that everything on this document is set to normal text. There's no headings, there's no bookmarks, there's no way to actually navigate this document in a digital form. And we have empty paragraphs here and empty paragraphs here, excessive use of tabs, and this is all not good. Wherever you have underlined or bold text, this really needs to be a heading or a title. Again, as a printout, it's fine, whatever. But for an online document, this is not going to work. Heading one, you only use once. Here we have heading two, then below that, heading three, back up to heading two again, heading two, heading three. And if I go to the punctuation marks here, you'll see that there is no empty paragraphs and no excessive tabs. Here we have a blank document where everything is set to normal text. It's all normal. You can't tell because normal text is not showing up in this stupid list. And so what we're going to do is under the Home tab and our styles, over here on the bottom right corner is this tiny square that brings up our styles window. And you can go ahead and scale this window to be any size that you want. It's pretty straightforward. Your most common styles are going to be right here at the top. If you want to change this order, go down to options. And then for recommended, you could go to all styles and hit OK. And that will then make this list substantially longer and give you access to every single style default. What we want to do first is add normal to our list because it's not already here. If you have it, awesome. We don't, so I'm going to go to normal and add to style gallery. There we go. So right now, as you can see, all of my text is just this default normal style. And I'm going to right click this style here, I'm going to modify, and we're going to add white space. These little icons over here in the middle area, I'm going to increase the amount of space before and after a paragraph and hit OK. And now we have all of these paragraphs spaced out. You can do the same thing by going to layout and then changing the paragraph spacing here. Do your spacing here, so I could do like 6 points before, 12 points afterwards, and then under the Home tab, normal. Right click and then update normal to match selection. That spacing will be applied to everything. So I find this modifying it by itself is the most straightforward because all my controls are right here. But you'll see that what these buttons do is they will add an equal spaced gap above and below the paragraph. If you want to have this not be equal, inside the modify style page, go down to format, paragraph. And you can also change that here. So 6 spaces before, maybe 12 spaces afterwards, and hit OK, and then OK, and it will do the same thing. Now that we have the normal text designed as we want it, we can now start going into things like header one, header two. Now again, my ribbon here is broken. I don't have the headers appearing properly. With the styles window open, I can just go ahead and when I click on heading one, add heading one here. Heading two, add heading two. If I'm going to be using these a lot, especially heading two, three, and four, I can right click them and add them to the style gallery, and they will appear over on the upper left. So now here we have the document with all of those headings applied. And what's nice about this is if we go to the View tab, there is a thing called a navigation pane over here. Which, if I enable that, it's going to show you the document structure over here on the left. And this should also be what people will see if you export this as a PDF file over there. You can take any of these sections and just by clicking it, left click and drag up or down to reposition these in any order. Now that we have our headings in place, and again, our paragraph is just set to the default normal text, let's go ahead and maybe give these headings a bit more variation. For heading two, for example, I do have heading two in my style gallery now, so I can right click over here and go modify. Could also go over here in the style gallery, so right click here or right click here. Wherever the style appears, just right click it to get to that modify style page. Most of this is pretty obvious, so the bold, italics, underline. Down here on the bottom left format, I'm going to go to border because border is where you give this a color. So the shading tab, I'm going to go to fill color. Let's go with a maybe dark blue and hit OK. If I hit OK, now wherever I have heading two, it's going to look like this. Heading three, same idea. So format, maybe I'll make it bold. We'll make the under the border color a background fill shading of a lighter blue. So maybe like that. Hit OK. Hit apply. We want a high contrast ratio. Having this black text on a dark blue background actually isn't going to be very ideal. We are better off with having this text be white. Under text effects, text fill, solid fill, yep. The color is black. Let's go over here and make it white. And hit OK. Now it's white. So see how much easier this is to read now that it's white on blue or dark blue versus black on dark blue? If that's too cumbersome for you, hit OK. Let's go down to heading three, for example, because on Home tab, the font color is just right there. So once you've changed the heading here, we can right-click on heading three in our style and then go update heading to match selection. And now we've got that yellow text everywhere heading three appears. It's pretty common to have a border underneath your headings. Same area we had for our shading, we're gonna go to borders instead. And then I'm gonna go with the solid border. And let's make it a black color with a width of 1.5. I'm gonna go ahead and make it on the bottom of the paragraph style. Hit OK. Hit OK. And now look at how heading three has a border. What happens though is if you wanna change this later, let's say I want to make this width a 6% or a 6-point width instead, and a dashed line. Notice how it's not actually changing under our preview here. That's because we need to actually turn off the border and then reapply it. And then now that we've reapplied it, now our changes we've made here will take an effect right there. So just keep that in mind. Before you hit OK, make sure that the changes you've set are being shown in the preview. If they're not, unapply it and then reapply it.